I was just asking how you know when your warm-up is done. For me, as a rider, as a trainer, I think, what do I want to accomplish in the warm-up? Every horse is a little different. Here, especially when the weather maybe is cooler sometimes, you want to have the muscles warmed up, but that's only a part of it. We want to have him quick off the leg, light off the leg, and maybe nice in the mouth, right? So that you can move him a little sideways, you can change his flexion, and half halting, coming back to me when I say to come back, and going when I ask him to go. But it's important that we go in, even in the warm-up, with a guideline, because if you don't have a plan, then we're kind of wasting all this time. And warm-ups can really be accomplished in 15 minutes. And then you can maybe school your horse for 20 minutes and you have a nice short ride and go for a hack. So let's maybe get back to the canter and we'll see if we can check a couple of these boxes off of our list as far as the half halting and the going from your leg in the canter. And then we'll let him walk again and we'll get to some work. Okay? And even here, if you're gonna ask him to go, the second, if that's your ideal aid, I want you to think about what your ideal aid is for getting him to walk from a halt. To me, I don't think that was it. I think you put it on, and then you put on a little stronger aid, maybe without even thinking about it. And the second you have to use more than your ideal aid, you have to make a correction. Good for you, but pet him. Before you stop him with the reins, pet him with your hand, okay? So that he doesn't feel corrected, that he feels praised first, and then you gently bring him back to the walk. Good. Yeah, but not fast left and right. You can keep the left rein a little and flex him to the right. And then check him off your leg again. I still did not particularly care for it. It looked to me like you had to use your spur. And if you really want to get picky, which I like to get picky, but I'm happy to take your spurs too. Don't worry about his face. I guarantee you he will come round. Yeah. Good, pet him though. Yeah. Even it's so against our nature to let a horse go like a giraffe. But sometimes we have to get over the fact that it doesn't look good for the sake of training properly. So don't worry, don't look in the mirror because you're not gonna like how it looks. Good boy. Okay, but that's the first step to getting him how you like him in the hand where he's light. Okay, nice off the leg equals nice in the hand. When something's not working, you're not gonna be physically strong enough to actually heave his butt to the right. So we have to make it maybe a little more simple, which we know he understands the leg yield. Good. Good. Now use less left leg. Good. And now make him bend through his whole body. Bend him around your right leg. Sit on your right seat bone. Ah, yeah, wait. Make him bend. Left hand down. Good for you. Now make your circle a little smaller. Good. Let's go the other direction. You can walk. Good boy. Okay, that's control. But you have to have all these pieces and be able to say, look, you know, look to the left. Now counterflex. Now bring your haunches more in. And then when you have all of that, then you can turn the shoulders. But when you let him dictate the pirouette, you're gonna be losing quality points. Okay? You have to be able to canter up to the exact point you want to turn him. And then half halt him, keep his haunches on that line, and turn the shoulders.